Welcome to our kitchen. I'm Peggy with a special welcome for you today. And we have good recipes, good food, and Rhonda Matthews, who is a good cook.
Oh, thank you.
From Clemson University.
That's right.
I work with Clemson. You got on your Clemson shirt. I love that.
Indeed. I am Tiger through and through today.
Good for you. And you've got meals that, you know, tasty meals for the family.
That's right. Today we're going to take a look at recipes that the vegetables are in season, so you can find them easily in the local markets. And every recipe we'll look at today is extremely flexible. So if you don't like exactly what we do today, everything that we're doing today can be tweaked to plenty.
Okay.
I started to say a little, but you can flex these a lot and turn it into something that your family will be pleased with.
So this is what?
So we'll start out with our, we're going to do a noodle, so to speak, and that'll be our spaghetti squash noodles, and then we'll do a meat and vegetable mix over the top of our noodles.
Okay.
That's right. So we're going to make the whole meal. So we're going to start out with spaghetti squash, and the name is correct. The strands that are inside this squash very much resemble spaghetti, and it is very welcoming to any kind of sauce or any kind of topping or flavoring that you put on it. It's good on its own. It's also good if you top it with anything. When you choose a spaghetti squash, if you've never bought one before, we recommend looking for one that has a unpunctured, perfect rind, and the rind is look for one that is dull yellow, and you'll get a good one then. Now this is a fairly small one, just a little bit bigger than a softball. They'll come out as big as almost a football. So anywhere in there is the right size. Buy one that will feed your family for one meal. So what we're going to do is we'll take a very pointed knife and pierce.
Okay, she's something else with that knife.
Now the thing about a spaghetti squash, like all the winter squashes, is they've got that rind is tough, and it is it does its job to protect the inside. You can leave these actually laying on the countertop for many days, and they will be perfectly fine. And so be careful as you open it up. It will take a little bit of elbow grease to get it open, so be prepared for that. So when we open it up, still pale yellow on the inside, you'll want to scrape away where you can see the seeds are. So the easiest way I found to do it, you can use any kind of spoon, but if you've got a handy...
That's like an ice cream.
That's an ice cream scoop, that's right. And if you'll just bear down in there and work loose those seeds, and I'll put those right there, and we'll scrape that out. Sometimes folks will save these seeds and roast them like pumpkin seeds. So we've got that one cleaned out. We'll clean out this one. All right. Don't be afraid to manhandle it a little bit. It's made for the long haul, so you really have to bear down to work with it. But it's worth the effort. Thank you very much. And so we've got it cleaned out now. So this gets incredibly easy. All we're going to do is turn it face down into any kind of baking dish,
and you
roasting
have nothing
pan.
On there. You have no oil on the bottom of the pan.
You're welcome to put oil.
But
it
you don't
does
have
not
to.
Need
okay.
it. You're welcome to put just a very small amount of water in there to help it steam as it cooks. It's not essential. It'll cook beautifully without adding that. You can cover it if you want it to cook just a little quicker. You can leave it uncovered exactly like this.
Now you
slide
bake
it
that
in the oven.
What?
350 degrees for a squash about this size, probably 35 minutes or so. And let's go ahead and slide this into the oven.
Okay.
And we have one already prepared, so if you could bring that one.
All right.
We'll take a look at what the finished product looks like.
There we go.
That's him. Okay. Very nice.
Here.
Okay. So.
I'll put this in, shall I?
There you go.
Okay.
So, You can tell it's gotten just a little bit darker. We cooked these ahead just so that our viewers could take a look. You can see that it roasted in this dish. This is the same dish I cooked this in.
It had nothing, no oil or anything in there. Okay.
Plain Jane. I mean, it just really doesn't get a whole lot easier. So we're going to let this be our base for every other recipe that we're going to do today. And as I take a fork, this is fork tender, and start to rake, you can see the strands turning loose.
Yeah. Okay.
Very tasty. Definitely has a vegetable taste, but it's a very mild vegetable taste. So you can add a tomato sauce, a cream sauce, any kind of cheese. You can sprinkle it with brown sugar and get almost a sweet potato taste. Very, very adaptable to whatever seasoning you add to it. This is just the beginning in terms of building up that flavor profile. If you will bring our big dish from down front, we will get our noodles onto our serving dish.
This is so pretty.
Thank you. My sweet stepdaughter made that for me as
a gift,
and I use it everywhere I go almost. It stays on my dining room table. So we're just going to rake. That's all we're doing. And we'll rake loose all of our noodles or our vegetable, our additional vegetable, and we'll mound that up in the center. And if your kids have never eaten this before, try it out on them. This is really a neat way to get just a few more vegetables in there. They may have no idea that there's a veggie out there that looks as much like pasta as this does. So, and you know, you may want to just sit it on the table and zip your lip and see what happens.
This is a vegetable. Just
that's right. Just give it to them.
This is a new kind of pasta.
That's right. See what happens. You never know. Okay, so we've got that one ready. Let's grab our other.
Okay.
This one's even a little more roasted. It got a little browner, and so that gives it an even nuttier.
That doesn't matter.
It is good, actually. Yeah. It gives you a little bit more of a nutty kind of flavor to it. Anytime you get that browner
going, it's so pretty on that dish.
It looks good. That's right. And we do eat with our eyes as much as we eat with our mouth. If it looks good, a lot of times those folks that you're serving will dig right on in if they like the look of it. So we've got plenty of noodles as our base.
And I could actually... You can do anything with that you want to, can't you?
Oh, yeah. You could very easily put... thank you very much. You could very easily do a spaghetti-type meat sauce on this, and yummy. Any kind of Alfredo, any kind of nut, cheese, olive oil, butter, any of that, just really tasty. So what we're going to do today is
put some olive oil.
Just a dab of olive oil. It does not take a lot. And then we'll give it just a sprinkle. Now you can see I'm not measuring a single thing here.
Well,
it's very flexible.
Good cooks don't usually measure.
Well, it's one of those recipes that requires absolutely no measuring. You just get it on the plate is really what it comes down to. So we've got our base ready to go. Now
that's all there is to it.
That's it. It's really that easy.
All right.
So let's go ahead and get our stovetop talking to us. And I think I do have the right eye turned on. So we're going to work and add everything to our one master dish.
So this will be like a one dish.
Yeah, I would put this.
Great for winter time.
That's right. I would put this on our table, and we would have one big dish in the center of the table. So the next recipe that we will do will be what goes over the top of this. So we're going to do a quick saute of smoked sausage. Are we getting warm enough there?
Yep.
Okay, so we've got some smoked sausage. We'll do just a little bit of olive oil in there. Smoked sausage in there with it. And I'm going to give you...
In any particular kind of sausage? Or
This is just that regular smoked sausage that, you know, you buy it when it's on sale, 2 for $4 or 2 for $5 at the grocery store. And we always have a couple of those in my freezer.
And you can... a little olive oil in the bottom of the pan.
That's all it takes. Okay. That's right. With that, if we can get our heat to talk to us, we're going to... Also do, this is about a pound of smoked sausage. Now, if this is all the meat that you wanted in the dish, no problem. But today we're going to do the sausage and some chicken to go with it.
Oh, my goodness.
So we'll have a couple of different meats in there. So I'll let you go.
In the same recipe.
That's right, in the same recipe. And so we will let that work a little bit until...
All right.
Until we get some... I'm looking to see, is the heat on? The heat is definitely on. And we'll let that go until everything is cooked through. So
you just sauté this.
There it goes.
And that's
all
there is to it.
That's really it. Now, if you've got someone in your family who does not eat the smoked sausage or they don't care for the chicken, switch it out. This is just as good with...
So you could do it either way. You could do it with just the chicken if you wanted to.
Absolutely. You could do it with...
And you've got the chicken kind of cut up in bite sizes.
I do.
See?
Yes. Makes it easier to eat. About a pound of each. And you just give it a few minutes until we come up with it.
This is going to, and this would serve quite a few people.
Oh, easily five or six folks.
Yeah, okay.
Plenty for a family of three or four, and then dinner, or not dinner, well, you could do leftovers, but lunch the next day.
All right. Now, look, we are going, while this is getting ready, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back. And the recipes that we're offering today, I'll let you do.
Yes, ma'am.
It's recipe number 880. Tasty Meals for the Family with Rhonda Matthews, recipe 880. And if you'd like these, they're free. Thanks to Clemson University.
That's right.
With a Clemson shirt on here. And Rhonda, and just send us a self-addressed stamped envelope to the Peggy Denny Show, Post Office Box 1616, Greenville, South Carolina, 29602. And be sure to put that number on there, 880, and we'll know what you want and get it off to you. We'll be right back.